I'm Hope. I am an iGeneration youth reporter.
Hi, everybody. My name is Stephen Brault, back with another edition of I'm Gonna Read You a Children's Book. This is called Chicka Chicka Boom Boom. This is a bit of a tongue twister, so bear with me here, but I hope you guys enjoy it. Chicka Chicka Boom Boom by Bill Martin Jr. and John Archibald, illustrated by Lois Ellert. A told B and B told C, I'll meet you at the top of the coconut tree.
So first, just like, how did you get involved in the Literacy Pittsburgh Storytime Project?
Well, the Pirates got involved first, and basically what they did was they asked some players if they would be interested in joining. And I love reading. I've always loved reading. And I love kids' books because I think that they're just super fun. So I thought it was a good opportunity. My mom wanted to make sure I mentioned that every year at Christmas, we read the Christmas story, like the story of Jesus in Nazareth, as a little, like a little kid's book that has pictures. So I got used to, you know, reading and then turning around and showing the pages. Cause if you don't do that, you get booed at my house. So you gotta do it. So yeah, I love it though. I love it. I think, you know, kids reading is absolutely incredible. And, it made me happy as a kid. So definitely support it.
Yeah. I was going to ask, like, have you ever done anything like a story time before, but obviously your house, but have you ever done anything like virtually before like this?
I think at some point I have read other books. I always thought it'd be cool because I listen to a lot of books on audio tape, like when we're flying or when we're on a bus or whatever. And actually this off season, I listened to the entirety, all 7 Harry Potter books on audio tape. I really like it. So I've always thought it'd be fun to narrate a book as well. But I enjoy it, but very limited experience. Mm.
So Literacy Pittsburgh is an organization with a focus on immigrants and refugees, which means they come from different places. So why do you think it's important to be able to read to kids who might not speak English as their first language?
Well, I know a lot of guys who English is not their first language. I play with a lot of guys from Latino countries. And a lot of them will say that a lot of the ways that they learned English when they were kids was either reading or watching a TV show or something like that that was mainly in English, so that they were basically forced to kind of pick things up as they went. And I think that it's great. My brother has a very young son that is, you know, I mean, he's not reading on his own yet, but they make sure to read to him, but they also have one of their friends read to him in Spanish so that he can also learn Spanish as well. So it's kind of the same thing, but reversed, I guess. But I think it's great. I think it's an awesome learning opportunity, yeah.
Do you have any advice for kids who are trying to stay educated, stay busy, like during this pandemic?
Yeah, I do, actually. So I think that what's kind of lost on people is that it's okay, especially as a kid, because it can be kind of frustrating or like kind of nerve-wracking, scary times to kind of be different. And I was a very different kid, and I still am a very different adult. I've always loved fantasy. I've always loved fiction. So, you know, as far as like reading nonfiction books, it's never really interested me that much. And so instead, I get my kind of ability to have a larger vocabulary and be able to think on my feet by reading fiction books about wizards and, you know, dragons and Star Wars and stuff like that. So I think that being yourself can make things very entertaining when you're trying to learn stuff.
Yeah. So like you mentioned, like when you were a kid, do you have any like memories of story times or like reading stories from your childhood?
I can remember the first like time I remember being read to, I was actually in third grade because my teacher would read out loud to us the book called Hatchet, if you know that book, Gary Paulson. And I got this tattoo on my hands, which I don't suggest, this is not endorsing getting tattoos, but because it kind of got me into really reading fiction a lot, and I still do. That was the first time I really remember being read to. Obviously it happened before that, but I was too young to really remember it. My favorite book growing up was Where the Wild Things Are. And the Rainbow Fish, I always get it mixed up because Shel Silverstein has a book called The Giving Tree. And so I always mix them up because I love both of them. And in the rainbow fish, he does give away his scales. So it's very confusing.
Yes.
But yeah, I love those books too. Shel Silverstein is awesome.
So could you tell me why you chose to read the three books that you did? So The Rainbow Fish, Don't Let the Pigeon Drive the Bus, and Chicka Chicka Boom Boom.
Okay, well, I already talked about The Rainbow Fish. I love that book.
Yes.
Chicka Chicka Boom Boom is fun because reading it is a hassle. I had to do a few takes on that because the first take, I was just all over the place and I couldn't get all the letters in order, which is kind of sad because you think at this age, I should probably know the alphabet. But the other book, Don't Let the Pigeon Drive the Bus, that one was provided to me by Jonah down there. I don't know why she chose that book. I honestly, like, that was a very strange book. I don't know what the message is that we're trying to give to kids. It's like, is the message literally to not let pigeons drive buses? Because that's what I got out of that book, I think. But it was entertaining, I guess, so that's cool. What, Jameson? What do you want?
Do you miss baseball? And are you practicing at home?
Yes, I miss baseball a lot. I love baseball. I love it so much. It has been very, very good to me, which is awesome. But also, I just love the game. I think it's awesome. So yes, I miss it a ton. But I am working on it, but I'm actually not at home. My home is in San Diego, which is all the way across the country from where I am in Florida. But this is the place where I thought it was best for me to be to get my work in. So I worked out this morning and I threw a bullpen. So if you want to check up on me, I'm throwing four, 5 times a week, all right? And I'm making sure to work out 4 times a week. I'm throwing 2 bullpens a week. So I'm there. I'm staying ready. I'll be ready to go when we're back.
What have you been doing in the coronavirus?
All right. Well, let's see. So actually, this has been a really cool time for me because I've been able to be in better contact with my friends. Because of playing baseball, I don't get to see my friends all that often because they live in San Diego. And then I went to college in Denver, which is in Colorado. So I have friends in Colorado. And I have friends in Minnesota where I played summer ball. And I have friends in Florida where I live now. And I have friends in Pittsburgh. So all my friends are spread out all over the place. So I've been playing video games a lot. And so have they, because none of us have anything to do. And we play together and we have our headphones on and we talk about life while we play video games together. So it can be a very good process of actually, I think I know my friends better now than I did before, especially when they get really angry when they lose games. Can I get a virtual high five? Boink. 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 Thank you.